Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. Please like and subscribe, and please check out my intro video. In 2 minutes, you can find out all about me, where I've been, where I'm going, what my goals are. Also, there will be a link to this painting at the end in the description. Might be changed a little bit because sometimes I work off camera on these also. Last time, did a birthday cake. I've decided to get back into my Whimsy series. If you've watched some of my YouTubes, you know that I paint in a lot of different directions. The bulk of my work is the Blue Ridge and surrounding mountains, but I like to do abstracts, I like to do people, I like to do lots of different things, and I like to get into real expressive, what I kind of call zonky colors, which are not what I do with my Blue Ridge paintings. And I was real pleased with how this turned out. I really like the pushed red down there. I like to really push colors and just get real strong color contrast. In that series, I have a number of heart paintings. And I was looking through those today, and I worked real hard to come up with a lot of different approaches to them, so I'm not sure what I'm going to do this time, but I did want to add some more. There's not that many, pretty many, and I will have a link to my Whimsy collection on my website for you to look at them. Most of them are one object that I've turned into something that I think is a very creative painting, and others have more than one, but I really couldn't decide what I wanted to do today. I do think I will let the paint move around a little more. The last one I really was using it kind of thick. So this time I think I'm gonna let it move, use a lot more water. And I was also thinking, the only thing that I was thinking of approaching, only kind of thing I was thinking of trying, which I've done before, is to really separate the warm and the cool colors. I did that last time, and I always end up adding the warm into the cool and the cool into the warm. But I thought I would start with that and then see where it goes. Of course, we all know a heart really isn't this shape, and I made it real fanciful this time. It's kind of a bulbous shape, but this is a great symbol that we've used. And since we're coming up on Valentine's Day, I thought, well, why not? This might be fun to do. Well, as always, I'm very serious about what I do. I think a lot of people misunderstand when artists use that term fun. They think you're not really serious, or yeah, you're just kind of playing around, and that's not true. Creative, I guess, is the word I should use. I'm going to be very creative. Also fun. I like to really just try different things in these YouTube ones, as those of you that watch know. I like to just really... I hate to say the word play around because people misunderstand, but yeah, play around. All right, yeah, getting real pinky here. I think I will, just for right now, just pretty much stick to the warm colors. And then on the outside, I'm gonna get into some cool colors and then probably go back and forth. It is bleeding some, I'm not letting it bleed a whole lot. It is bleeding some, and I wanted that to happen. As I've mentioned before, when you let water media bleed around, you get really interesting effects that keep changing until it's dry. You think it's going to look one way, and then you do something else, go back to it and see it's dry. Whoa, that's not what I thought it was going to be. And it's a really great type of water media, great technique that those that work in water media are really into. And I'm essentially an oil painter, as those of you that watch know. I don't do a lot of water media, but I do on YouTube because I go fast. My oil paintings take a long time, and I don't really want to do the time lapse. One of these days I'll probably do one, but you know, they take a long time, lots of layers, and who needs to see a time lapse of that? It's just too much, in my opinion. I work in the traditional thin to thick, getting it very thick at the end, where you got a very thin layer, and then the next one, you dry, you get the next one, until it's done. And then I usually have the paint pretty much coming off in areas, more and more as I work in oils. I become more and more interested in making this plastic look where you've got shapes actually coming out towards you. So it's not really wall sculpture, but it's kind of like it. All right, I haven't used a whole lot of colors here because I was sticking with the warm. So I'm going to now clean off my brush and do some cool colors in the back, and then I bet I'll just go back and forth. I have a lot of really nice blues. I couldn't believe it last time. I left out a blue that I always use, but sometimes when I'm getting ready for these things, I'm thinking about lots of other things and I get mixed up. And then I'm painting, I thought, oh crud, I'm gonna tear that color out. I'm gonna tear that color out. I don't wanna stop, because it's so easy to drop things all over the place, which I'm really good at doing. And that's kind of embarrassing when you're trying to do YouTube. Okay, I kinda like that contrast. Not real complicated though, by having the paint really move around, it's not real complicated. If you've watched these, you've heard me say ad nauseum that I really like complicated surfaces, complicated systems of brushwork, complicated colors, just lots of stuff going on. So this is, so far, to me, kind of plain. I'm sure to a lot of people, not plain at all. But to me, it's kind of plain. So I'm probably gonna go back into it. It's only been a few minutes. Might even let it dry, but it's gonna dry in places as I work. So that's always nice. And I got two of the blue greens out this time. There's one that I always love to use, the phthalo, and this time I got the one that's more, even is bluer out too. Yeah, I wanted more of a loose heart, because if you go to that section, that collection, you're gonna see most of them are just a really very typical shape of the heart. And this time I wanted to have something a little looser. Not so, less stylized. Okay, now I'm starting to really think I need more. I'm not using white yet. Probably gonna start to use some white to get a lot more variety going on here. Because so far I'm really not really interested in this. It's all right, but don't think it's that good. There's one I really like that I did. If you go to that collection, look up Heart Energy. I'm so pleased with how that one turned out. Really, really interesting effect. All right, well, not happy. Not sure what I'm gonna do. Probably just gonna have to add a whole lot more paint. I might get a smaller brush, see what happens. Let's see, what do I wanna do? I'm not even sure. Maybe I'll do more with that really nice acid green I like and smaller brushwork. Yeah, I like that. And I'm gonna, of course, get warm into the cool and cool into the warm. I never completely separate them out. But that's part of that is what I see. And what I do is essentially, even though it's abstract, it's based on what I see. And when you look at a shadow out in among leaves or grass or something, well, you've got some warm colors in there, but the shadow is essentially cool. So you have them both playing off of each other. And to me, I just think that is so beautiful. Now, right now we've got all this snow around. And when you have that, because of the white surface, all the colors together, you see a very precise separation of the two colors. You don't have them mixing so much. And under certain effects, you can really, really see the warm colors on one part where the sun is shining, and then really strong cool colors. Depends on the type of day. I mean, I'm looking outside right now and I bet most people just say it looks gray, even though it is kind of blue, the shadow. But yeah, it just depends on the atmosphere. But you see these things more in the evening and in the morning than midday. Midday, it really can get such strong contrast that you don't really see it very much. I like that better. But it's still kind of boring. I've come such a long way with this type of painting because I used to only work representationally, the way things look. And then I started to say, I want to do some abstracts. I want to do some things where I'm just really letting things happen and I'm not basing it on something so much, but I'm just really, really letting it happen. And I've come, as I said, I've come a long way in that. Because it was not something I was, trained to do, or just chose at the beginning. I know that when I was in school, I would do things that I knew that a lot of very serious-minded artists would think were kind of sentimental, and based on being pretty. And I remember one friend said to me, you know, I had a teacher who said, art shouldn't be pretty. He hated hearing that. And I said to him, you know, if I'm gonna spend my time doing this, I'm gonna do what I want. If I wanna do a baby, I'm gonna do a baby. If I wanna do flowers. I'm going to do flowers. Like, oh, no. Have an awful senior moment right now. One very famous artist, but that's what happens when you get old. And I'm certainly not young. Can't think of her name. Oh, well. Anyway, very famous artist said, you know, when they criticized her for doing flowers, she said, well, you know, you got to look at my flowers because she made them huge. Why can't I think of her name? You know, I'm sure you're all sitting there thinking, how come you can't think of that name? Of course you know that name. Maybe it'll come to me. I hate that. Extremely famous artist, and right now I actually can't think of her name. Hate that. Oh, well. Yeah, maybe if I get some more interesting brushwork, too. Because this is kind of, to me, it's kind of dull. And the bleeding areas are, you know, they're not dry, but they have kind of bled in there. And there's nothing real exciting to me there, so no point in worrying about saving them. I'm going to do some more purples. I like this, but it's just not nearly as complex or as interesting as I like a painting to be. I didn't like that. It's kind of taken away from the heart. So what I'm doing, that I've explained many times, is I'm balancing between control and accident. I'm deciding to do something, and then letting things happen, and I'm deciding, do I like that? Do I want to change that? It's quite a process that you can't explain to anybody. You have to do it, I think. I think you have to really be involved in what I do to really understand what I'm talking about. It's not bad, it's just that I want a lot more going on. But I'm just kind of repeating myself and it's not really doing a whole lot. Might have to spend some time off camera and just keep trying to figure out what it is I want with this painting. I think having the brushwork is helping. That's making it more interesting to me. So I'm really going more with the thick stuff. Getting into a more traditional acrylic painting. Starting off with the thin and now I'm really building it up. Acrylic or oils. Generally that's how they're done. You gotta watch these absolute things. You know, it's really a problem in art. And it's so easy to get into, especially if you teach. I really fought that very much when I taught at Radford University, to not say, you got to do this, you got to do that, because I was told that a lot, and I think it was very wrong. There are things that can help and lead you in certain directions, but to say, you can't do this, you have to do this, that's no good. That's just, not great, in my opinion. So I would just try to get the student to figure out their direction. There's a zillion directions you can go into in art, and you gotta figure out what is right for you. Not real happy with this. But yeah, I do think it's helping just to turn into more traditional one. Just not happy with this. Oh well. I'm still gonna use it and still put it on my website. I don't think it's terrible or anything, but it's certainly not as good as some of the other ones that I did that are hearts. Well, like I said, I can go back into it afterwards and maybe I'll come up with something that I think is more interesting. It's getting better. I think the contrast is starting to help because the heart is really standing out now. So that's making it better. Let's see, maybe I can, like I said, warm to the cool into the warm. George O'Keefe, finally. I hate that. Can't believe that. I had a friend that taught also, and she said she couldn't believe it, that there were times, as she got older, that she would forget an extremely famous artist's name while she's lecturing. It's like, oh! I know when I was lecturing, lots of times I wanted to point out different other artists, writers, and actors, musicians, and it would drive me crazy when I have senior moments for that. But I would. Okay, I'm starting to like it now. Yeah, it needed to have more going on. Just needs more. I think even though I've got some that are bleeded, just almost completely bleeded hearts that I like very much, think this one needs to be complex. It needs to be more of a traditional painting. And now it's starting to get some good things going, finally. Don't want to go too much longer because, as I said before, there's something wrong with our computer, cache, whatever it is. We need to get a new one. It takes all day long to load these, upload these. This one is 15 minutes. It's going to take 7 hours. Really frustrating. Got a young friend working on getting us a new computer because we don't understand them as well. And haven't heard from him lately, so I'm going to contact him again. Because I think it's all it is. Our computer is outdated. All right, I think I'm going to stop there. Even though I'm going to work on a little bit more off camera and get a little more complexity going. Thank you very much for watching. The link to this painting will be at the top of the description. Link to my Whimsy collection, my Etsy shop, website, and other sites that have my work.